Hello and welcome to the channel. These inequalities are very well known. In case A and B are real numbers, which is what assumed in this video, both inequalities turn into equalities if and only if A times B is non-negative. This means that either at least one of A and B is zero, or A and B have same sign. There are numerous sources proving the inequalities. However, all the proofs I've seen end up with checking different cases. When both A and B are positive, both negative, or have different signs. That really annoyed me, so I started thinking of a proof covering all the cases at once. That's what I've come up with. The vertical bars denote the modulus of a number. The modulus of a real number is its absolute value, which can be defined as the maximum of the number and its negative. From the definition of absolute value, it follows that the absolute value of a number is always non-negative. And a real number never exceeds its absolute value. While a number can be equal to its absolute value, if and only if this number is non-negative. It can be easily proven that the absolute value of a product is equal to the product of absolute values. In particular, square of a real number equals the square of its modulus. Consequently, the arithmetic square root of the square of a number always exists and equals the modulus of this number. That's all we need to prove the inequalities, so let's move on to proving them. As start we write that product A times B is no more than the absolute value of A times B, while the equality holds if and only if A times B is non-negative. Next, we multiply both sides of the inequality by 2, also replacing the modulus of A times B by the modulus of A times the modulus of B. Now we add A squared plus B squared to both sides of the inequality. While doing that, I replaced in the right-hand side A squared with the square of its modulus and B squared with the square of its absolute value. You've certainly guessed what is going to be next. Indeed, we rewrite the inequality as the sum of A and B squared is not greater than the sum of moduli A and B squared. Given that square root is a monotonically increasing function, we can take square root of both sides, then replace each square root with the corresponding absolute value. Then we notice that since absolute values of both A and B are non-negative, the sum of them is also non-negative. This means that taking the absolute value of the sum is redundant and can be removed. Thus, we obtained precisely the first triangle inequality, and we only need to mention that this inequality turns into an equality if and only if the inequality we started with turns into equality. And this happens if and only if A times B is non-negative. Now we can place a tick indicating that the first triangle inequality has been proven, and move on to proving the second inequality. Again, we start with the familiar inequality. A times B is not greater than the absolute value of A times B. However, this time we multiply both sides of it by negative 2. Therefore, the inequality sign changes to the opposite. And again, we add A squared plus B squared to both sides. And again, factorize. Take square roots and replace them with absolute values. This time, the outer vertical bars cannot be removed, as the difference of absolute values can be negative. But this is not a problem at all, as the inequality we obtained is the second triangle inequality. And again, it turns into an equality if and only if the original inequality turns into equality. It asks A times B is non-negative. And we place the second tick and say the end.